Hey, what's up there? My name is Thavius Beck. In front of me, which is over here, because my camera's off to the side, in front of me, I have Bitwig, and I have a project with 5 tracks, and no clips, and I have this lovely Komplete Kontrol S MK2 keyboard, and I'm planning on making something with Bitwig and this keyboard without touching my mouse. That's the goal. There's new integration that allows me to do quite a bit just using this keyboard, and that's what I plan on doing. So, I've got my tracks here. I want to add some content. I can navigate through my tracks using the big knob over here, and I can move up and down through my tracks. I can move left and right through clip slots. And when I'm ready to record something, I can just press the button, record right into a clip slot. It's pretty cool. So let me press play to get a sense of my tempo. I'm going to turn on my metronome. Nice. And I think I want to start with something rhythmic just to give me a little foundation to go with. So I got this little 808 kit here. All right, so I'm just gonna record a little rhythmic idea very quickly. I'll just press the button to start recording. All right, I've got my record quantization on right now, but if I didn't, I could just press the quantize button to lock that in. I think that's actually okay right now. So before I add anything else, let me go down to this Gecko Blaster here. I want to get some sort of little bass line going here. Let me turn off the metronome though before that drives me crazy. And here we go. Okay, not mad at that. Now I've got some macros here that I might want to play with before I add some other stuff. So I'm going to go into the MIDI mode here and start playing with these macros a bit. Okay, maybe I want to automate this, make it a bit more dynamic. I'm going to press my auto button here, but not yet. I'll do it now. Okay, not bad, not bad. Got a little arpeggiator situation down here. Might be a little loud. Let me go to my mixer, and here it is. I know you can't see the screen over there, but I love the fact that I can see the volume meters as if I was using any other Native Instruments device. Nice. Let me see. Do I want to play with something on the macros here? Oh, I think I kind of have to now. Let me see. All right, everyone needs more cowbell. We'll throw in a little cowbell, why not? All right, and yeah, we'll bring that down some. Don't need quite that much cowbell. All right. So let me go to my juke kit, add a few more drums here. Ah, getting the right octave. And maybe we'll do a couple different variations here. So let me give myself a 4 on the floor kick. Move over to the next clip slot, and I'm going to give myself more of a broken beat type kick pattern. again. There we go. All right. Let me go ahead. There's a bit too many things playing here. I'm going to go ahead and mute my arpeggiator and that cowbell. There we go. Cameras over here. There we go. So this kind of gives you an idea of just how you can stay in the flow. And the more things you can control with knobs and buttons and tactile features, the more you can stay in the groove, feel less like you're editing a spreadsheet. And I like this integration quite a lot because the hardware feels good. The DAW is amazing. So any way to make it easier to interact with it is going to be a benefit and a plus. So with that said, my name is Thavius Beck. Thank you for your time and attention. And hopefully you'll get a chance to get your hands on the keys, dabble with the DAW, and make some wonderful music. Until next time, take care.